Thanks for checking out this movie review video. So this is for the 2021 film, The Call. It is a Shudder exclusive, and it's coming to Shudder on Thursday, July 15th. So since this review is coming out before that, it is a no-spoiler review. I will just give you a very quick little synopsis of it, basically. And then, not too much, actually, because I don't want to ruin anything. Because if this is a film you're interested in and you want to watch, you should definitely watch it. Now, I say this all the time, especially with films I'm not a big fan of. I didn't really like this film, but I will say, I'm going to repeat this. Every film, in my opinion, is worth watching at least once just to figure out how you individually feel about that film. Just because I wasn't a big fan of this doesn't mean you're not going to love it. And I've already seen some people out there on social media talking about really enjoying this film, and that's great. There should be a fan base for every single film, and there pretty much is. So just check it out if you have interest in it. But I will tell you my thoughts on this film right now. Directed by Timothy Woodward Jr., who also did films such as Finders Keepers, The Root of All Evil, Seven Faces of Jack the Ripper, which sounds like an interesting title, Gnome Alone, yes, actual like little gnomes, and The Final Wish. I have not seen any of these films, but I will say, based off what I see in this film from a directorial and cinematography standpoint, there's some good pedigree there with Woodward Jr. as far as directing and an eye for cinematography and the cinematographer he's working with. So there's some good stuff there. My biggest problem with this film was actually just the script. The script was the biggest issue. It was written by Patrick Stibbs. Speaking of the script, this is his only credit. So this is the very first script he's ever done. You can see maybe why there were some problems for that reason, but once again, like I said, some people might like it. I did not. It has the big names in this one. Lin Shaye, you know, obviously everyone knows Lin Shaye most from the movies like Insidious, The Conjuring, you know, all those types of films. She's been in a lot of films over time, though. I think my favorite role of hers was actually in Kingpin, the Randy Quaid and Bill Murray film Kingpin. Oh, I'm sorry, and Woody Harrelson. How can I forget Woody Harrelson? He was in that as well. So I think that's my favorite role of hers. I'm sure a lot of people love her in that role, but she does a good job in this, as you would assume, because she's a very seasoned actress. And Tobin Bell is also in this, and Tobin Bell also did a really good job in this. I think my favorite parts of the film are when Tobin Bell is on screen delivering his lines. I really do feel like he kind of steals the show, and he just really kind of chooses scenery as much as he can. Like I was saying, I don't feel like the script is that good, so I really do think that Lin Shaye and Tobin Bell really did the best they could with what they were given. And for that matter, the actors in general, some of them are really not very good at all. Some of them are okay, other than Lin and Tobin. But I think they all kind of tried to do what they could with the material, you know, to varying degrees, really. But just my thought on it. So, like I said, to repeat, coming to Shudder Thursday, July 15th. Now, this quick synopsis, I don't want to give you too much. So, it's basically about some friends. I think they're in high school. I believe they're in high school. They get involved, have kind of an altercation to a degree with a local woman who's kind of, you know, everybody knows about this growing up. There's always like that house or that person in the neighborhood that people kind of whisper about behind their backs and say, oh, there was a murder there, or this person's crazy, they're a shut-in, you know, all that type of stuff. So Lin Shaye's character is kind of one of those people. These high school students have a run-in with her, things don't go well, and then she ends up dead. That's not really, you know, spoiling much, because that's not what the film's about. So these kids then are contacted by her husband, played by Tobin Bell, who says, interestingly enough, you were left in her will, but in order to get the money, there is something you must go through. And that's where I'm going to leave it. So interesting concept, I do think. It's set in the 80s for some reason. I can't really figure out what the 80s was bringing to it, except maybe just the ability to easily ignore cell phones. That's my only opinion on it, because I don't see, like, otherwise, I don't see a reason to have set this in the 80s, unless, you know, the writer of the film and or director of the film just really liked the 80s, so they're like, I just want to set it in the 80s. It just feels very arbitrary. You could just set it in times now, and there are other easy ways to kind of explain away cell phones, but, you know, just saying. There's a lot of fluid motion camera work with movement around things and following characters, which looks really good, which is what I was kind of talking about directing cinematography. It keeps things engaging from a visual standpoint, but at certain times it actually does kind of go a little bit overboard, where in particular there's a moment where the students are together with Tobin Bell and he's kind of explaining things. And there's a lot of camera movement. Like every single shot, it's the camera's moving like from side to side on characters. And it really starts to feel very overboard, almost to the point where I was feeling like I was almost getting motion sickness. And I'm like, ugh, that's a little, yeah. But just saying. The score hits a very nice tone for the film early and really does enhance the overall film for the most part. But it kind of devolves towards the end of the film into being severely repetitive. You start to hear the same stuff come up over and over and over and over again. And it's not, like, great music. So, I don't know. And just, like, sound-wise, there are certain sounds that they use throughout the film to signal things that very repetitive. Just keeps happening over and over and over. There is a lot of repetition in this film, too, and I'm going to talk about another aspect of it in a little bit. The dialogue is rough. It's overly simplistic and creates a barrier from seeing much of any personality for most of the characters. It also makes everything feel extremely choppy. Many films, I will compliment them if the dialogue is really good for having conversations that feel really realistic. These conversations feel very detached, like you're kind of missing part of the conversation in a sense. And for that reason, like I'm saying, it's very choppy. It comes off very choppy and unrealistic and simplistic. And just the dialogue's not good. It's not good dialogue, really. And it doesn't develop anything, really. It just kind of seems like a bunch of the writing in this. It's just there to move things to the next plot point for the overall story. I think there really needed to be more time taken with the script to kind of work things out. The characters are paper thin and oftentimes just do things to move the story forward with no real reasoning. That's another thing. There are a few very key things that end up happening in this film that have to happen in order to move things forward, but should have been done in a different way that feel more realistic, because there are definitely things that characters do where you're like, really? This person is going to do this? But then maybe, again, that's supposed to be hearkening back to the way kind of a lot of horror films were in the 80s, where people were just kind of doing dumb things just because, you know, everyone remembers watching those 80s horror films, especially slashers, being like, why would you go into this room? Why would you go into the basement when it's dark? You know, things like that. So maybe that's what they were going for. I don't know, but it doesn't play that well, at least not nowadays, in my opinion, for a newer film. But other people may enjoy that about it. There are scenes that are held a bit too long, which kind of takes you out of the film because you're kind of, because it ends up feeling kind of like that moment after a conversation kind of ends and people are still standing there and neither person knows what to talk about, but you're still just standing there looking at each other and waiting for each other to talk. Like that moment of like, okay, I think we covered everything. Now what's going on? Like those are the moments that get hit when these scenes are going a bit too long. And there's a good amount of those that happen in the film. Really, those scenes just needed to be cut a little bit earlier when it came to the editing portion. So, yeah. And for that reason as well, it kind of messes with the overall flow of the film as well. Nice shooting locations and set design. I will say that. They did a really good job with picking the shooting locations. They look really good, appropriately creepy, sets up good atmosphere, and the design of them, really great job on that. Builds great atmosphere. The scares are unbelievably disappointing, in my opinion, especially because they're almost all exactly the same scare. This is what I was talking about with more of the repetitive stuff. It gets unbelievably old very, very fast. They just keep doing the same type of scare stuff over and over and over and over, and it's just like, where is the variety? And especially for a film like this that, you know, it's not written super well, the characters are not super interesting, it's an okay concept. You need something, and you need, like, good scares, you need good kills, you need that type of stuff, and it is definitely not there. It's not even close. It really took me out of it. It really made me feel like I didn't have anything to be interested in this film, really. And there were a lot of moments where it really did feel like they were just wasting time, just trying to hit a certain runtime, which the runtime's like, I don't know, I think it was like an hour and 37, 38 minutes, something like that. So like the runtime's not bad, but the story's not there to get there. And there's a bunch of other stuff that's not there to keep you interested, like interesting characters, interesting character interactions, scares, practical effects, all sorts of stuff. Very lackluster ending to the film as well, in my opinion. Just not very good. Once again, though, directing, cinematography good, music for the most part good, set design really good, and location scouting, great job on that. The script feels like it was a first draft that's plagued with poorly written characters, poorly written dialogue, and a bunch of things written out of convenience. Really does seem like a first draft. Like, really a someone trying to write a script for the first time, and it's their first draft, and they just shot it. Maybe people will think that's a little bit unfair, but that's the way I view it. But that's also why I'm telling you, just go ahead and watch it if you have interest. Because you might actually find something else in it. And if you do, go ahead and comment down here and let me know. You know, I think that I loved it because blah, blah, blah. You know, tell me, did you agree with me? Do you disagree with me? I'm always open to hearing other people's opinions because maybe you can enlighten me a little bit as to something I may have missed. You know, some sort of subtext that puts something else there in the film. The film is slow and feels stretched for a certain runtime. That's the other thing. So, that's all I kind of have to say about The Call. Not a big fan. So out of 5 stars with half stars in play, I'm going to give them a 1-star rating on this one. I was between 1 star and 1.5 stars, but I just think that the script writing is so low level that, yeah. I mean, that's the foundation for your whole film, really, and there's not really much that anyone else can do. After they take a script that's not well done, you know, you can't do a whole lot to fix that. Director, cinematographer, costumer, actors, actresses, like, and you'll see. I feel like a lot of people with the film did what they could, but the foundation's not there. So, 1-star rating on this one. Would love to hear your opinions on it. Go ahead and put it in the comments. We'll talk about that. Now, do me a quick favor, hit that subscribe button if you can. If you're already subscribed, thank you very much. Really do appreciate that. If you're not, literally takes a second, totally painless, and I greatly appreciate it. So go ahead and hit that. And also hit the notification bell button, because that way you'll know when I'm putting up new videos, whether it's one of my no-spoiler reviews like this, one that's full of spoilers and analysis, or an unboxing haul video, any of that jazz. But regardless, I really thank you for your time watching this, because it really does mean a lot to me. And until next time, keep it brutal.